The US Framing Design Guide indicates that a 2.4 meter long or 8 feet 2x4 should be able to carry around 150 kilos or 330 pounds of concentrated force applied at midspan. Today, we put this to a test. Let's see just how trustworthy the engineering codes actually are. I bought a few 2x4s randomly sampled from the lumberyard. To make the analysis more exhaustive, I studied the American, Canadian, and European engineering codes and determined what each one of them predicts for the carrying capacity of the 2x4. I know each code is designed for their own lumber markets, but in order to compare them, I have to apply them to one particular piece of wood. This makes the analysis a bit more confusing, since the species and dimensions of the 2x4 are actually different across countries. I know, it makes absolute no sense, but for example, in Europe, the actual dimensions of a 2x4 are 1¾ by 3¾, or 45 by 95 millimeters. Whereas in North America, the size is 1½ by 3½, or 38 by 89 millimeters. For an explanation to this insanity, check out my old video on the 2x4 dimensions. Before I show you my tests, let's apply the US code to the European 2x4. The approach is almost identical between the US, Canada, and Europe. As a designer, you're expected to perform a number of checks that satisfy strength and serviceability conditions. The serviceability requirements do not pose a direct threat to human life. They include limitations on deflection and vibration, which are concerned with the comfort of the occupants, but often do end up governing the design of beams. The strength requirements, on the other hand, if unchecked, could lead to severe consequences and possibly loss of life. In this video, we will only concern with the latter. More specifically, we will look only at the bending capacity of the 2x4. The bending capacity for this loading case is computed by multiplying several coefficients together, each accounting for different environmental conditions. Keep in mind that this formula is specific to the case where a single point load is applied to the middle of the beam. For a uniform load, the formula is slightly different. The most important values here are the section modulus S, which accounts for the size of the board, or more correctly, how difficult it is to bend this cross section. FB is the other crucial factor, which captures the strength of the wood species and grade of lumber used. In this case, I'm using a European spruce 2x4, C14 grade. This corresponds to an unfactored capacity of 14 megapascals or 2000 psi of internal stress. This number is based on the 5th percentile strength, which we'll discuss a bit more later. Keep in mind that this is the pressure at which the wood grains are expected to rupture, which is different than the applied load denoted with PC here. The rest of the coefficients account for the type of structural system, moisture exposure, duration of loading, and so on. Let me know in the comments if you would like a more detailed video on that. While you're down there, don't forget to subscribe. There's a lot more testing on the way, so you don't miss out. Now back to the equation. Multiplying all the factors together gives the total code capacity of 296 kilos or 653 pounds. Keep in mind that I'm applying the US code to a European 2x4, which is slightly larger, and the wood in Europe, for whatever reason, is graded insanely strong. A similar number is obtained using the Canadian code as well. The Eurocode, on the other hand, predicts a carrying capacity of only 155 kilos, almost half of the strength predicted by the North American codes. The main discrepancy originates in the load duration factor, where the US code allows for the strength to be increased by 60% when the load is rapidly applied between 1 and 10 minutes, whereas the EU code does not account for that. In the long-term loading scenario, say 10 years or more, all codes converge to the same low value. The weakening of wood over time is a huge topic, firstly discovered by Wood in 1951, but that's a topic for another time. Now, let's see which code is right. I performed a total of 4 tests, which by no means is enough, but it does indicate a general trend. The state of the boards was quite poor, lots of large knots and damaged corners. The first 2x4 failed very abruptly at a peak load of 344 kilos or 758 pounds. The failure originated from a large knot close to the loading point and came within 15% of the code rated capacity. I was blown away by the code accuracy, but this is just one sample, so I kept going. Board number 2 also looked quite poor, but still managed to exceed the code rated capacity. It is worth noting that the deflection was already quite excessive at around 300 kilos. I doubt anyone would be comfortable if their floors were to deform to this degree. But here we are testing the ultimate strength, so we'll ignore this horrific serviceability failure and keep going. Board number 2 reached a peak load of 601 kilo, or 1325 pounds, before losing its stiffness, which is more than double the code capacity. Note that the failure here happens gradually. The peak weight was recorded as the maximum load capacity. Board number 3 had a slight twist to it, which got magnified as the loading progressed. The bottom side of the beam splintered at a peak load of 604 kilos, unbelievably close to the second test, which is very untypical for a highly variable material such as wood. The fourth test reached a mind-blowing 740 kilos or 1631 pounds, 2.5 times the rated capacity. Even though four tests are quite few for a statistical analysis, it is clear that wood holds an ample reserve strength. Also, it is very evident that wood as a material has a highly variable capacity ranging from 340 to 740 kilos. The codes came in lower, at 155 and 300 kilos. Note that I'm investigating a European 2x4, but the North American codes predicted its strength with a much better accuracy. But the question remains, why are the codes so terribly off? Or are they? Before you declare engineering codes a scam, bear with me for a little longer. There is something that we didn't address properly. Let us go back to the capacity equation and revisit the strength factor. As I said earlier, this is the 5th percentile strength, which means that if I test 100 2x4s, the 5th weakest board should fail at the code-rated loading. In other words, the value predicted by the codes are meant for the most hideous piece of wood, some of the worst 2x4s you could find, or in mathematical terms, the 5th percentile. So practically, we designed the whole structure based on the strength of the weakest link. You may argue that it's stupid to design structures for the weakest link since 2x4s never act alone. They are almost always in a structural system such as a stud wall or a floor where they act together as a unit. So even if one is weak, the rest will pick up the slack. This is a fair critique and one that the code takes into consideration. The US code in particular allows for a 15% increase in rated capacity when the 2x4s are used for floor assemblies. This is still far off from the average strength value, which based on our 4 samples was close to 572 kilos, almost twice the code capacity. Since I tested only 4 boards, chances are I did not test the weakest link, so I got a false sense of the strength of wood. Since wood is highly variable, as we saw earlier, its strength probability curve is spread out. In essence, it has high standard deviation, which pushes the tail of the curve containing the weakest link quite low. Hence, explaining why the code conservatively sets the capacity low. But regardless, in light frame construction, the quality of the connections and the skills of the framers are arguably more important for the sturdiness of the construction. Remember, this video is not an engineering advice. To help me produce more content, click the subscribe button. It costs nothing. See you next time.